that no sucker. I came from the bottom, but I'm coming to the top. Let's test your will. How much faith do you got? Your foot's on the line. Will you ever take a shot? Score the game when it points when it's zero. The clock out. Came to find that life's a test. There's no cheating either. Just work and stress it. No money's provided. You're eating less. Bills on the table and pain in your chest. You promise you'll pay for the things that you can. You want the whole world, but it's burning in your hands. You ask for help, no one hits you in the stands. A crowd full of friends you can never call fam. They love you then, but they don't love you.
Bellwood-Antis High School gym. And for tonight's basketball game, the Mighty Lady Blue Devils will be taking on the Hornets from Juniata Valley. Good luck to all the players in tonight's game. And make sure to subscribe to the BA Blueprint YouTube channel and click on the little bell to receive notifications when we will be live next. Bellwood is on defense now. Juniata inbounds the ball. And Tina Holland is pressing hard. Juniata is passing down the court. They take the shot. Bounces off the rim. Holland has it. She passes it down to Lighting. Lighting's outside. She passes it out to Kara Angle. Lighting's taking it up to the hoop. That's not in. Taking it down the court. Juniata plays some hard defense. She passes it out to Holland. Holland passes it out to Shook. Juniata taking it down the court.
No score here could be indicated from the tough interior defense thus far.
She's struggling to get open. Bellwood has the ball back, but Tina's moving it down. They pass it out to Lighting. She takes a shot and it's in.
Bellwood has the press on right now. Let's see if they can get a pass half court. Bad pass. Juniata. They're going to take some time to get over.
Trying to work it downfield. Downfield, down court. It's out of bounds.
Livio Musselman really working the defensive position there.
Lining inbounds at the angle.
Juniata Valley's press easily broken there.
Out to Shook. She has a shot, but it's not in. Juniata's ball. Juniata working to pass Bellwood. They take the shot, but it just doesn't fall.
Kara Engel with a nice rebound inside there to change possession.
She goes from behind the back, but passes it out to Holland.
Foul on the floor here against Juniata Valley. Shook's going to inbound pass it. Or top to Lighting.
Lighting. She takes a shot, but doesn't go in.
You take a look at Musselman down there. She's really fighting for the ball on offense and defense, knowing her role underneath as a post.
Juniata inbounds the ball. Bellwood trying to cover him, but Juniata works it down. Trying to get an open shot.
See, Bo, this is what makes Bellwood's defense so outstanding at the very level of JV. They're already practicing that tough press. And it's so hard for teams at this level to break it.
Yeah, you can see they're just draping Juniata constantly. Trying to let them not work down the court. They get past them anyways, but they miss the layup.
Shooting foul on Musselman. But back to the post, you see here it takes three, sometimes four passes just to get past half court line for the Hornets offense.
The shot doesn't fall. And the Hornets sub in a new player.
Out comes Woodring into the game for the Hornets is Hall. Second shot off the mark.
She rebounds it but doesn't get it. Juniata still has it. They take it out. She fakes a shot. And it falls.
Juniata Valley won the inside on that possession. That's why they were able to get some rebounds. And in fact, they got a basket in exchange.
Bellwood trying to get an open shot. Holland takes it. Doesn't fall.
Great ball movement here by Bellwood spreading the floor out. But unfortunately, they just can't seem to get the lid off the basket, which it'll come.
Juniata is now up ahead by 3 points at 5-2. Another foul on Bellwood. And Bellwood subs in another player.
Now entering the game, Macy Decker.
Struggling to catch a pass. That's an air ball. Holland passing it down. And that's another foul.
You can really see here that Holland and especially Leidig are really kind of carrying the offensive flow here for Bellwood. And that's what I like to see, considering you see later in the games, Leidig is going to be one of the first off the bench, averaging about 5 points a game. She really contributes not only at this level, but at the varsity level as well.
She inbounds it to Leidig, but her shot doesn't fall. Tip by Leidig.
Leidig back on the offensive.
She's down in there, and that'll be a foul. She will get a shot.
Two shots here for Leidig. Already has 2 points, I believe, in the game.
Bellwood is still down by three.
Bo, I'd just like to say this. Varsity, this is a big game tonight. Just because this is a junior varsity game does not mean that the implications are any lower. This game will set the tone for the big game tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, really get a mood going. Get the crowd in the zone. And get ready for this varsity game.
Major ICC implications on the line tonight.
I'm excited.
Doesn't look like many changes for Bellwood. Same five out. Mm-hmm. Leidig back to the line.
Passing it, and that's out of bounds. Bellwood is now up 6-2.
Both of these games, you're going to see a lot of momentum shifts just by shooting streaks, hot and cold. Again, Leidig really pushing the offense.
That's two more points for Bellwood. Bellwood just trying to do the best they can covering Juniata down the court. That's out. Allie Wagner will be coming in for Kara Engel.
See, in big games like this, you'd think you'd really want your starters out there, but it's just as important to get them on the bench, get their legs to freshen up a bit, because it could be down to the wire very last second.
Nice take by 23 from Juniata. Biding, trying to work something on offense, but doesn't get it. Shoot, in the bound, but that's a good ball.
Lighting in there with the pump fake. Went, forced the contact, trying to get the foul. Unfortunately,
that
there wasn't a call.
On Juniata. Lighting takes her shot. Doesn't make it. Rushing down the court, Tina Holland on the ball. Juniata will be inbounding the ball again. And it's out again. 41.2 seconds left in the first period. Oh, and that's not out. Biding will be taking it down the court. As she looks to move the ball around. She shifts with the shoot. Tina. Pass it back to Lighting. Lighting out to shoot.
Great ball movement. This time a foul called.
Bellwood keeping Juniata on their toes.
See, if they're
time left.
If they're not working the post, they're working the perimeter, trying to get a pass outside or inside. Really effective offense that comes with a lot of ball movement, and that's exactly what Bellwood's doing early.
Shot doesn't fall now. Juniata's taking it back down. She's right back on it. She knocks it out and spells its ball again.
Oh, Leidig tipping it out of the way.
Down the court. That's a layup. Two more for Bellwood.
Only a 10-4 game. The score really not a big indicator of how well Bellwood's been doing on offense. A lot of these shots have just not fallen off the rim.
Yeah, they've really been maintaining good control offensively and defensively.
Juniata Valley coach really stressing the idea that they're getting stuck on both sides of the perimeter, not really working the inside, but a lot of that has to do with Musselman really handling the post really well at her position. A lot of the upper side of the defense not allowing any passes inside the post.
Mm-hmm. All right, the players will be stepping back out. Tina's hustling down the court. They're moving the ball around. Looking to get a shot. Shoot. Doesn't make it. Juniata with a long pass down the court. They try to take it up. Just doesn't go. Juniata keeps it in. Looking for a hole in the defense. But all also seems to struggle to shift the ball around. Good pass, and that's a good layup. 2 points for Juniata.
I don't think that's much to really worry about for the Bellwood defense. Unfortunately, that is one of the holes that comes with help defense. You're especially in the post, you got two there. In a zone, if you slide to the right side, you're going to expose that back end, and unfortunately, if someone's there, that could be an easy basket for the offense.
Ready to take this ball down the court. Some good ball movement. And that's two more points.
Great pass by Shook. Sets up that basket by Musselman.
And that's an easy layup.
2-on-1 situation, almost at 100% efficiency with this team.
Bellwood with the great defense.
Pass up
good
to Logan.
Passing. That's just outstanding. Really seeing a lot of good team chemistry. These Bellwood girls out here tonight.
Great dominance in recent years from Bellwood can probably mostly be attributed by team chemistry as Leidig tries to tip it back in.
Almost touched. She's just
everywhere.
She's just dogging the Juniata defense right now. Bellwood will not let them have anything tonight.
I think if you're Juniata Valley, you just take it out, try and slow down the tempo here and reset.
They really need to pick it up. And goals of the Bellwood defense.
So we got a blocking foul on the ground.
Juniata will be inbounding it.
Besides the press and the potent offense, another thing you'll notice from both of these Bellwood teams is they're always getting their hands in the lane. They're always tipping passes, and that leads to high steal numbers, high turnover numbers for the other team, and eventually that could lead to open scoring drives.
Yeah, they're just really putting a lot of pressure on that Juniata offense, and that's what's causing them to make slips and mess up from time to time and get those turnovers. Musselman with a good defense. Trying to shift the ball around. That'll be a jump ball. Juniata trying to put a lot of pressure on the offense, but
again, almost the Shook Musselman connection underneath on a 2-on-1 scenario. Unfortunately, layup is off the mark.
Bellwood just seems to be eating up the press, and Juniata just can't get to the hoop quick enough to cover it.
Even on the inbound pass, you can see here they're spreading the floor, and I think that's going to set up for an open shot sooner or later in the possession.
Holland taking it to the hoop. Doesn't get it. Engel with the inbound, or the rebound.
Engel really showed some strength there to get that shot off with about two or three different hands in the way.
And she really got up there to get that rebound. Lighting with the shot, and it falls.
Tell you what, Leidig's really got the hot hand, and because of that, Holland's really racking up the assist numbers.
Juniata, just trying to get, trying to move the ball around so they can get a shot, but it just can't work out for them.
You see now that Juniata Valley for quite some time has really abandoned the idea of their press, and they're just going back on defense, probably trying to keep up with this Bellwood-Antis tempo as they march down the court.
Yeah, the Bellwood-Antis offense just really seems to be just a little too fast for Juniata right now.
Unfortunately, I think once we get to the varsity level, though, I don't think dropping back to play defense will really benefit the Juniata Valley defense. I think they're going to have to find a way to really suck it up and keep up with the Bellwood-Antis
tempo. Really try to shut them down and keep them from scoring as much as they can.
With the score 16-6, Juniata Valley head coach really, really pressing the idea that the offense has to get kick-started here, and let's see how they react to that.
As this game gets on rolling, Bowen will be getting the ball. And it's a far pass out to Sheep. She'll be taking it up the court, showing what moves she's got. Lighting, trying to work the shot, passes it out to Shoot. Doesn't get it. Juniata Valley getting some movement on the ball. Really need to get open and get a shot here. That's a nice layup. Why has it to Angle? She takes it up the court.
Back to that offensive possession for Juniata Valley. Lexi Reed, number one, only stands 5 foot tall, but she's really been working the offensive movement and has been finding ways to get down into the post. Really see how that pays off later in the game.
Juniata Valley, a little slip up on offense there, a little misunderstanding. And they're back and they're trying to work again.
Reed again, almost gets one to go down. Tips the ball out.
She tries to work on defense, but.
Great job by Engel there to make sure that pass gets back out and so the ball can continue to move.
Bellwood keeping up with the good ball movement. That's a nice pass.
Awesome and great pass, yes, in the angle in the lane. No one there for defense. I'll tell you what, but if you take a look over there to the opposite bleachers, you really can start to see some of the students are piling in. They can tell that this is going to be a big game tonight.
Angle with the pass. Holland just can't get big enough to get that ball.
Too much sauce.
Yeah.
still down by 10. Struggling to get some ball movement here. A nice pass out, and that shot falls.
Great shot.
It's deep, too. Holland working it in on the offense, but doesn't get it.
Jump ball possession goes to Juniata Valley. Great heads up play there by Reed to get her hands on the ball. Reed trying to make things happen.
Holland with the rebound. She's trying to take it down. She gets the shot off before the buzzer, but.
Just too much sauce on the shot there. Looked good, just a little high. Brandon Bickle in the house. Again, student section really starting to fill up. You can feel the intensity, the atmosphere starting to build. This is effectively for the ICC North tonight. It's always nice to see, though, that the students can show up a couple minutes early, half an hour early, to see the JVs get in so they can have their moment in front of the fans. I think we should look ahead to the varsity game a little bit. And what do you anticipate? What do you think you're going to see tonight?
I think we're going to see, in the beginning, Swagger, Damiano, and I think Campbell all working in the offense and getting a good lead, possibly, and then them trying to work in some of the people on the bench and trying
to keep. Yeah, I think you're right. These teams last met up January 17th. Bellwood was actually down for the majority of that game, but they actually ended up winning 53-42, an 11-point win. In that game, they had to use everyone on the court. Everyone had to get involved, scoring, rebounding. And Coach Swainy actually made a point the other day in practice to these players that a big factor in that win was rebounding. You had 2-3 players in double-digit rebounding, which was effectively able to continue some of Bellwood's possessions on offense and some of Juniata Valley's possessions on offense. So they need to continue that tonight, and we'll see if that is effective. For all the viewers at home, tonight's game, a win for Bellwood, clinches the ICC North and subsequently a third seed in the playoffs. But a loss of more than 11 points will bump them out of ICC contention, and they will also be guaranteed the fourth spot in the playoff bracket.
can really feel the tension starting to get higher as the players are starting to warm up and people are getting in here, and the crowd's just getting more and filled up.
Yeah, I can agree with that, especially since we're on the Juniata Valley side. I can actually feel some of the hatred, not gonna lie. Mm-hmm. But of course, we are just the announcers, so don't shoot the messenger.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I'm sure everyone in this gym would like to see a good game, but as a Bellwood fan, we'd love to see Bellwood come out on top.
I mean, I'm always down for a good game, but hey, whatever happens, happens.
Lighting might actually be done here. Oh, they're back out shooting for the second half. Leidig's probably going to be the sixth person off the bench. Even that, if her sister Elena doesn't get the start, she might also be in contention for that first person off the bench to really help out in getting some points, getting some offense, defense, and resting up legs of the other players.
And that is also going to be a major key for Bellwood to just keeping the team fresh and keeping the players going so they can always stay on edge.
15 players on the roster, that gives them a lot of depth, but a lot of players can really come into that varsity level and still help out. But the thing is, their depth is matched and even taken to the next level by one. Juniata Valley has 16 players on their active roster. So both teams have the depth to make this a really good game, and I think that's why the last game was really down to the wire. But the varsity squad is definitely a mix of both seasoned veterans here, 4-year starter, 3-year starters, but they also have their fair share of freshman sophomore. You have you got a stud in Allie Campbell, freshman starting. She's averaging 16.4 points a game. And you also have Riley D'Angelo, who's also can get the nod to start, and she can also have a factor. Averaging about 7.8. but can also pass the ball to the tone of 3.2 assists per game. Really, I think it's the idea that you're not too top-heavy when it comes to class. You can have people from freshman, sophomore, junior, senior class really come in and score a basket, play some tough defense.
And that also says something about the future of the Bellwood basketball team.
But to that same token, I think that this is going to be a rivalry game that we're going to see for a while. Not only does Bellwood have plenty of underclassmen, Juniata Valley actually has the Altoona Mirror Player of the Week in Haley Smith, averaging 15.3 points a game, 2.2 assists per game, and 6.5 rebounds. That's enough, like I said, to give her the nod for Altoona Mirror Player of the Week, and I'm sure we'll see a lot of her tonight, and she's just a freshman.
I got a feeling we're going to be in for a good show tonight.
Coach Longo making her way back to the bench. About 2 minutes will be underway for the second half. Lots of familiar faces in here, Bo. We got Coach Hayes over there, athletic director, the man who you could say is responsible for building Bellwood-Antis into an athletic powerhouse, not just on the football field, on the court, on the baseball field, and on the track. The man gets it done. He really cares about the athletics here, and he does his job well.
Looks like the players are getting ready to get back out here for the second half as coaches are making their final suggestions to players.
Same starting five back out there for the second half, and I think you can expect to see more or less the same. Same performance, same style of play from Bellwood.
Hopefully we can just see the same type of intensity on the offense and defense from Bellwood in the second half.
I'll tell you what, if Juniata Valley expects anything to get inside, you are guaranteed to see Musselman have something to say about that, a hand in the way, anything just to prevent some offensive play down the post. And some sportsmanship as she helps up a Juniata Valley player.
Down the court. She gets a foul, but not the points. The first shot falls. That sets Bellwood up by 9. She breaks the second one, and Juniata is moving the ball down. They pass it outside. It's a good rebound from Bellwood. They lose it, get it back, maintaining their momentum. Hong with the shot outside, doesn't fall.
Off the backboard, rebounded by Holland.
She's moving it down, passes it out to Lighting, and that's a good layup. 2 more points for Bellwood.
Emily Lighting is also a freshman, and I think because of how well Allie Campbell has played this year, she kind of goes under the radar, but she is definitely, without a doubt, someone that Bellwood is happy to have coming off the bench, if not even getting a nod to start.
Juniata trying to get a shot.
Ooh, hard foul, hard
they
foul.
They get a foul. She's slow to get up.
A little bit of pain. She'll take the shots, though.
And that will be another foul for Bellwood as Musselman comes out.
I'll tell you what, you get 5 fouls for a reason. Just got to know when to use them.
Good defensive play by Angle. She passes it out to Lighting. Lighting fails to get the layup. That's Juniata's ball now. She's back on defense already. it's going to be Bellwood's ball. As Lighting inbounds it to, or as Angle inbounds it to Holland. Layup and Kara with the foul.
Trainer Jesse Glass just got done working with Catherine Hopsicker on the Juniata Valley bench. We'll have to see what's going on there after she had that hard foul. Hopefully, we hope for the best for her, and hopefully she can get back in the game.
Bellwood keeping good movement of the ball, maybe. That's a jump ball. Juniata. Out of bounds.
Not enough sauce.
Holland's going to take it down the court. She makes a nice pass and gets out the Lighting. She goes for the step back.
Nice.
Cash.
Buries it.
Now on defense. Not letting Juniata have anything.
Bellwood in this. Six points in the quarter for Bellwood, zero again to Juniata Valley. Shoot nearly got in the passing lane there to tip that off, just wasn't that fast enough.
Juniata still seems to be struggling with moving the ball around, finding the holes in the defense.
Reed, nice spin.
Holland with a nice pass. Shoot back out to Holland. Lighting with the shot, and it falls.
Tell you what, if I'm any other offensive player for Bellwood, I would be looking to get like half and the whole game altogether.
Be a timeout for Juniata. As Bellwood is up by 17. Look ready to rock and roll. As Bellwood is slow to get onto the court.
You know, looking at the banners on the wall here really kind of reminds me we should probably say something about Joey Padula's performance last night, where he reached the 1,000 point milestone. Probably the highest goal that one could reach in scoring. So congrats, Joey.
Chance to talk with Joe earlier today, and he said that he feels pretty good and that he's really proud of getting 1,000 points.
Yeah, I had a chance to speak with him too, and I actually asked him how it felt, if he was excited. Nice block. But back to Joe, he really said he wasn't even that excited, and his actual main goal for the season is just to win a district title.
Yeah, so he really, that's what he also said. He said he was really focused on winning games instead of getting points. As Juniata makes some changes to their starters. Biden gets the ball and it's in. Nice pass. That's going to be two for Juniata.
Tell you what, Bo, a lot of black starting to pour into that student section over there, and they're getting ready. It is a blackout night. But you can really tell it's going to be a big game. There's a lot of faces from Juniata Valley that are here to make the game. Not usually something you see at a game this level, that opposing students from the other school will come in and see the game at an away event.
Juniata still struggling to get the ball. That's another jump ball.
Another Hornet player getting up gingerly there. Holland being a little scrappy there to come up with that ball, and especially when she didn't get it the first time, she got back on defense.
Lighting passes it to Holland. Shoot gets it. She takes it in, and that's two more for Bella.
With the score 31-12, this Bellwood offense can pretty much do whatever they want to get inside the interior zone of that offense there.
The clock winding down with 9.5 seconds in the third. Juniata really needs to get some momentum going so they can turn this game around. Sauce on that shot.
Another big indicator that you can tell this is a big game, the intensity's rising. You can look down at each end of the court, both locker rooms. Every once in a while you'll see a Juniata Valley, Bellwood player peek out of their respective locker rooms. They're ready to get going, and I'm sure the last seven minutes of this game is going to build a little bit of that anticipation.
Bellwood still looking to keep control of the ball. Great job. It's still rolling. Juniata gets it back. Not if Lighting has anything to say about it. Holland. Lighting looking for a shot. Passes it out the angle. She shoots it, and that's in. Nice
perfect shot. Nothing but net. I don't even think it hit the fibers of the net as it went through. That's perfect. On offense, but unfortunately they just couldn't hit the shot.
She gets a nice easy layup as Juniata Valley just seemed to let it wide open down low.
Timeout for Juniata Valley. One remaining, 5 minutes, 42.
So it looks like we see some new faces on the Juniata Valley team. Holland trying to work her moves. She has a nice open pass to Musselman.
Wow, way to get her own rebound there and put it back up for the and one call.
She gets the and one. Nice play by Musselman. Good shot from Musselman. Right through the net.
The hands of Reed.
Juniata trying to get some movement. They get a shot, but it's another air ball. Holland taking it in. That's another layup. Two more for Bellwood.
Good job by Holland there to use up all her steps and get to the hoop. Protected the ball the whole way. There's no way that was getting blocked. Up and in for an easy layup. With Reed converting there, that is just their fifth point of the half.
All with the rebound, she passes it out to shoot. To Musselman, all with the open shot, and that's in. Three for Bellwood, baby. looks to get a good hold on this Juniata offense. Musselman not letting them get the shot off. It's going to be Bellwood's ball. Shot from Musselman. Doesn't fall. It's back out to her. It's another shot. It's off the backboard. Musselman just not letting Juniata get a shot off. It's another air ball. Shoot. Passes down to Macy Decker. Tries to get a pass, but it's stopped by Juniata. And they're going down court. I think for the first time we've seen Leidig and Holland out in the game.
Yeah, usually you have at least one of them on the floor. But again, they're a pretty integral part coming off the bench for the varsity squad, so they got to get some sort of rest in between.
And with not much time left in this game, and Bellwood with a nice lead, they can get all the rest I think they deserve.
Yeah, 44-15. I think it's pretty fair to say with 2 minutes, 25 seconds left, this one's in the books. The recurring theme for her, as I said earlier, that jump shot, it's like it just goes perfectly through the net. It barely even touches the net. Again, a great three-pointer for Engel.
Ball stays moving. Juniata passing around. Looking to go to the hoop, but Bellwood just stops him like a wall. With the foul shot, but first one's going to be an air ball. Rebounded by Engel. Musselman.
Tell you what, they just matched their entire point total in the past 45 seconds of what they've scored in the entire second half alone.
Although Bellwood still has a nice lead, they are maintaining good pressure on the Juniata offense.
I think some of these kids that are in here getting some playing time, this is pretty valuable for them, because this is another practice time for them. They're getting ready for the varsity level, whether or not it's later on this year, next year, or just down the road. They're preparing for their time on varsity, and it's pretty important. Great pass into the post there. Jump ball call goes to Bellwood. Five left.
Bank just not open. And that's the game, folks. Their final score is 49 Bellwood, 20 Juniata. This broadcast of the basketball game is brought to you by Blue Devil Nation TV. Special thanks to all the students and staff helping with tonight's broadcast.
And here comes a whole lot of energy, I'll tell you what. Whenever the music starts playing and the varsity teams run out, that brings a whole lot of energy to the fans, the players, and the anticipation for this game goes absolutely through the roof.
Looks like the Juniata Valley girls are coming out on the board, starting up their warm-up.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Bellwood-Antis Lakewood Basketball. Tonight in an ICC game, in the final regular season game, the Lakewood Elves posted a record of 19 wins and 2 losses, welcome to Juniata Valley and the Hornets, standing in with a record of 18 wins and 3 losses. The official assignment to tonight's game are Ms. Sarah Pye, Mr. Don Donaldson, and Mr. David Wright. Before we announce the starting lineups, will you please stand to honor America with the play of our national anthem? Now for our starting lineups. First, the Juniata Valley Lady Hornets. David Junior, record number 10, Sydney Reed. David Junior, record number 14, Taylor Buckley. David Junior, record number 33.
And now for our Lady Blue Devils. She stands 5'10". She is a freshman. She wears 21, Allie Campbell. Standing in at 5'6", she is a sophomore. She wears number 10, Riley D'Angelo. Coming in at 5'9", she is a senior. She wears number 11, Sophie Damiano. She stands 5'8". She is a senior. She wears 00, Michaela Carls. And rounding out the starting five, 5'8" senior, wearing number 3, Carson Swagger. Our Lady Blue Devils are coached by Jim Swaney, assisted by Kylie Longo-McGarvey and Ryan McGarvey. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a couple of announcements before we start tonight's game. Fans, you are reminded that concessions are not permitted in our gym area. Feel free to consume those in the gym lobby. Bellwood-Antis has approved a tobacco-free policy. Therefore, all forms of tobacco are prohibited on school grounds. Fans, when you are leaving the gym area tonight, please use the exit on the side of the gym that you are seated. Do not cross the gym floor at any time. And one last announcement here, ladies and gentlemen. Here at Bellwood-Antis, sportsmanship is an expectation. So let the coaches coach, let the players play, let the officials officiate, and let you, the fans, support your team. Thank you.
From Juniata Valley. Good luck to all players in the next game. And make sure to subscribe to the BA Blueprint YouTube channel and click on the little bell to receive notifications when we do our next. And it looks like Bellwood's already scoring their first points as Juniata tries to get the ball moving on offense. Good take from Juniata. That's only two more points. No. Juniata trying to get that shot to come down, but it just doesn't. Carson moving the ball over here. Does a great job of getting to the hoop, but just can't get that ball in there. Juniata moving the ball around in there, she's gonna lay up, not a look like two. Gamble looking to pass. Or again, open shot, she passes to Carls under the hoop. That's an and one.
Great strength there by Carls to be able to fight up and get that basket in for the and one call. We'll see if she can convert it.
We're already seeing a lot more excitement here in this game.
Already starting to see that rebound battle underneath the interior defense. Anything that has to do with that is going to be a big factor.
D'Angelo is looking to get to the hoop, but they're having Carls. Good job of keeping the ball in. Bellwood doing a great job moving the ball. Campbell to Carls. That's another layup.
Carls always seems to be in the right place, especially last time these two teams met. She had 10 points, three assists, and five rebounds. So she's definitely going to try and be as big of a factor tonight as she was then.
Juniata failing to get their points. D'Angelo passing it down to Campbell. She takes a shot, and it just doesn't fall. Damiano wide open down low, and that's an easy layup.
Damiano getting some scoring in, usually a really big factor. She's leading the team in rebounding, 5.5 rebounds a game, but anytime you can get her in on the scoring is big for the offense.
It's a nice effort from Juniata. Campbell trying to get under the hoop.
A lot of contact on that shot, and we'll see if that's going to continue from the referees.
Beautiful Euro step from Juniata Valley. That's going to be another 2 points, and this game is already neck and neck. Swagger with the shot.
Off the mark. Both teams with some tempo.
Almost getting the and one with Juniata.
So far right now, Michaela Carls is leading the scoring for Bellwood, and that's pretty big because, like I said earlier in the JV game, anytime you can mix the scoring with this team, it'll affect the offense greatly. paper or something here? Yeah, just say excuse me, I'll get up there. So an unfortunate turn of events, my esteemed colleague here, Bo Potter, has a bloody nose, so I'm going to be taking over the commentary for the time being. D'Angelo in the corner, shot up and good. So Bellwood up to a 13-9 lead right now. And that really brings back memories from the first time these two met. D'Angelo really hit a big three. That three really put away the game late in a game that they weren't winning for most of it. Swagger pass up to Campbell. Great assist. Up and in. And a timeout is taken by Juniata Valley. You and I were talking about earlier in the game, big momentum shifts, big runs can be changed here. And just like that, this is a six-point game. This is as close as you can get here in Bellwood to a packed gym. Everyone excited. Again, I have to say, this is big ICC North implications. Bellwood wins this game, they clinch the ICC North. If they lose, they drop down to the fourth seed in the playoffs. And if they lose by more than 11 points, the points differential falls in favor of Juniata Valley, and Bellwood will be knocked out of the ICC North contention. Swagger's going to take it up the court. She drives in. Foul on the floor here for Juniata Valley, and that's their second team foul. Nice dish back out. Damiano to the perimeter. Campbell, it's good. There's an assist for Damiano and another 3 points for Campbell, who now has seven. Bad pass, Damiano up on the point. Knocked out of bounds. Looked like it got last touched by Juniata Valley, but they will maintain possession. Swagger, covering Tyler Lighty. Great defense here for Bellwood. They're not allowing anyone in the lane. Shot up, block, but they will call a shooting foul on Allie Campbell. Head to the line will be Hayden Taylor. Bellwood up an early 9 points, 18-9. Looks like the official is going to change the foul call here. They may have messed up on who the foul was called on, and they're going to take care of that right now. K Taylor's foul shot off the mark, so Bellwood will maintain a 9-point lead. Swagger drives in, takes it down, and she's fouled on the shot from the post. She'll head to the line now, looking to expand Bellwood's lead, which is right now at 9. Swagger has 0 points right now. That's what you can expect. And she converts on the first basket of the game. With that free throw, Bellwood increases their lead to 10 points. Second free throw is good. 11 points now, 20-9, with a minute 54 seconds left in the first quarter. Taylor Lighty takes it down the court, the pass to the wing. Over is Haley Smith. Again, keep your eye on Smith, a freshman, but again, she was named the Altoona Mirror Player of the Week for her scoring and all-around play. And my colleague Bo is back.
You miss me?
How are you feeling, Bo?
Oh, phenomenal. Just get plugged in here. Alrighty, what I miss?
Well, okay. Bellwood's up to a pretty handy lead right now. Balanced scoring is what you could probably summarize their offense as now. Mm-hmm. Swagger just got her first points on free throws, and you got to hand it to the Juniata Valley defense so far for having a pretty solid day, just covering Swagger and keeping her from scoring. Mm-hmm. Swagger averages 28 points a game, Blair County's all-time leading scorer. So she's obviously, bad fouling call, travel here. But back to Swagger, you know you're always gonna face potential double teams and just tough defense whenever you are that much of a prolific shooter.
Yeah.
Last time they met up, she had 22 points, and we'll see if she can repeat that. Smith drives in the lane, the spin, pass underneath.
It's a nice shot. That's nothing but net. Gamble.
Juniata Valley fans not liking that call. Lots of contact though, so we'll agree with the ref on this one. Leidig passes it out. Great heads-up play to find Campbell open.
Campbell looks for a shot. She passes it out to Leidig. She's going to take it to the hoop. She misses the floater.
Leidig can't convert, but she was on fire during the JV game, so you'll have to look and see if she can continue that streak in this game.
Swagger with a nice...
Oh, what a pass!
What a beautiful pass.
Absolutely, what a pass.
Great assist by Swagger. Good layup by Campbell.
Holy cow. That was a no-look behind-the-back pass from Swagger. Elena Leidig called on the foul. Smith will convert on the foul shot. She was able to convert 16 points last time they met up with Bellwood back on January 17th. Misses the second.
Elena Leidig gets a rebound on that. And Bellwood's already down the court.
Nice screen set there by Damiano to allow D'Angelo to get out to the perimeter.
Campbell trying to get the ball away. Bellwood still moving the ball. Swagger with the shot.
Oh!
It's just not enough. She looks to Looks like the cheerleaders will be coming out for a little performance. Student section is already filled up, and it's somewhat of a blackout, and somewhat students.
So after one quarter play, we really saw a tight game at first, then Bellwood ran away with it. And now, score 22-14, Juniata Valley has a little bit of the momentum there towards the end of that first quarter.
Just kind of started to creep back up. Close it.
I'm sure Coach Sweeney for Bellwood's going to do something about that, tighten up the defense. But a lot of these points have come off of foul shots for Juniata Valley early. That can either mean that Bellwood is being aggressive, very aggressive on defense leading to fouls, or the opposite, Juniata Valley's being smart, looking for shots, making contact to initiate the fouls in the post. Finding the ball, it was right between her legs there.
Campbell off of Damiano. D'Angelo. Swagger looking for a shot. She's gonna take it to the hoop.
Another shooting foul. Whenever you see Bellwood move like this, it really shows how many tools they have out on the court. They can all score, and they really benefit from the ball movement that they've created here early. Points now for Swagger. Oh, a lot of contact on the screen there. Michaela Carls in the scrum.
Carls with the fake there.
Yeah, she's able to.
Swagger.
Great pass.
Nice
find
pass
the hole by Carls. You got to finish there, Bell. Got to finish. Now this tempo you're seeing right now might be some of the fastest basketball that you'll see in this game. Swagger, the pass into Damien. Hey, look at that scoreboard right now, though. Look how balanced that scoring is. 4 points, 3 points, 5 points, 4 points, 9 points early. No lopsided scoring. That's really gaining a balance in the offense, and that can attest to the 25 points here in the first half. Michaela, calm yourself. Settle. You see a lot of walks earlier here today, Beau. What do you think? You think that's nerves? You think that's excitement trying to make a play?
Someone.
deep three.
Another foul on Campbell. That's her second already here in the second quarter. We'll see if Coach Sweeney's gonna take her out to avoid further foul trouble. She still has three left, but you gotta think there's 5.5 minutes left in the first half. Stepping up to the challenge right now. A senior just came out of the game for her, and she's stepping up. She really wants to compete. Bellwood's done a good job on both ends of the court to really control Smith. You know, that's not that easy to do. She stands 5'10". She's fit to play basketball, I'll tell you that much, and it takes a lot to control her there. Same five out for Bellwood.
Swag with the fast take.
I'll tell you what, that's something that Juniata Valley does not want to let happen, is let her get hot, because when she's hot, she will not miss. Second foul now on Riley D'Angelo. Tina Holland's gonna step in to avoid further foul trouble.
Come on. Juniata just couldn't seem to lay that ball in the hoop as Swart takes it down the court. She's gonna be trying to see what she can get. She goes for a floater, but.
I think Swagger was looking for a foul there, try to get to the line and further the lead, but unfortunately, I don't think she got the call. absolutely buries it from the perimeter. And I'll tell you what, I think Campbell's building up a night she wants to remember. Already has 12 points, and she's been shooting it lights out.
Carlos with some good defensive play. Not letting Juniata get nothing.
Carl's had some great defensive play there. After a turnover, she kept it going with another great defensive play to get up in the way of the shot, and that caused a miss.
Tina Holland takes a shot. It's off the rim. On defense, and Juniata can't draw the end one. Juniata's gonna get a point.
Two for two on foul shots there.
Campbell getting open. Lighting trying to pass it out to Campbell.
Juniata Valley defense really pressing here. And because
going
of that,
offense,
they're able to force
just
an
not
air.
On the same page there. Great defensive effort by Bellwood right there. Campbell with the floater. She's not going to get it. Holland trying to keep good defense. Water. She's got the ball. She takes it to the hoop.
Oh!
And that's in. Where is it? Never mind.
I'm going to tell you what, but I'm really surprised that wasn't a foul call. After getting some fresh legs, Damiano and Leidig check back in for Campbell and Holland. And it appears Coach Sweeney's been consistent on, you know, subbing these girls in and out, avoiding foul trouble, getting them some fresh legs.
Nice pass out to Swagger. She's got a shot off. She can't get it. Some good ball movement from Juniata.
So because of the eighth team foul on Bellwood, Juniata Valley is now in the bonus. One and one situation, the first one is converted. And just like that, this is back to an 11 point game. Now a 10 point game. 40 seconds left till halftime, and we'll see if Bellwood can try to steer some of the momentum back in their way.
Swagger. Carl's with a shot. She can't get it.
And that shot was right there for Carl's. That just unlucky bounce off the rim.
That's going to be another foul on Bellwood. And that's going to give Juniata the chance to get some more points.
With 25 seconds, Bellwood's really got to try and control the bleeding here before half. Two shots here, and it's an 8-point game. Swagger slows it down a little bit. You can tell she's trying to control the tempo.
Campbell taking it to the hoop. She keeps it in bounds. They're moving the ball. Swagger.
So we're going to head to the half with an unlikely 8-point game here. For a while there, it was looking like we were on the precipice of a blowout, but like we said earlier in the JV game, you can expect momentum swings here strictly because of scoring streaks, cold runs, and unfortunately Bellwood was just a victim of what was effectively a cold run there towards the end. Couldn't get the ball in the basket. Is going to be the winner.
It looks like that's going to seal it.
Someone's the lucky winner of $10 tonight. We'll find out who that is as Mr. Bill Damiano announces the winner. So the players and coach is back out for the second half. They'll shoot around for a little bit. As we said earlier, Bo, you can tell there's some big implications to this game. It's a big game for both schools by the amount of students that show up from the away team. Actually, that's kind of surprising. There's been a big turnout for Juniata Valley, and you can think that that probably has to do with the fact that Juniata Valley and Bellwood share some animosity in whatever sport it is, football, baseball, any sport that they compete in. They always strive to beat each other, and it's usually Bellwood that comes out on top.
Yeah, so there is always a good history of friendly competition between these two schools. And it's always nice to see that.
Unfortunately, in terms of football, that rivalry, probably one of the bigger between the two schools, it didn't they didn't compete this year. They didn't play each other,
yeah.
But both had some solid squads.
Swatter seems to be getting a little stretching in during their warm-up.
You can see some of these girls are trying to get some of the shooting woes out that they, you know, unfortunately were diagnosed with a little bit towards the end of that half. A little couple of the shots that went up just were there, just couldn't seem to go. So they're going to try and perfect their shots here the last couple minutes before the half. But like you said, with Swagger stretching out, sometimes being a little tight, being uncomfortable can sometimes lead to some missed shots. And I think maybe she's just trying to calm herself down a little bit, feel a little bit better for the second half.
And just a reminder, this broadcast of the basketball game is brought to you by the Blue Devil Nation TV. And a special thanks to all students and staff helping with tonight's broadcast.
You have to remind yourself, Bo, just how big this is for the Tech Club, for the Blueprint, and for the school in general, just to be able to have live broadcasts. I know you broadcasted a couple wrestling meets, but hopefully Kermit and the staff can really get this going as a future, you know, priority of some of these games, a given, because I know for some of the parents, the players, this means a lot that they can play on a live broadcast.
Yeah, and if you want to make sure to catch all these live broadcasts, make sure to subscribe to the BA Blueprint YouTube channel and click the little bell to receive notifications when we'll be live.
As So Juniata 5 back out on the court. And we'll see who Coach Sweeney sends out. Both starting fives back out.
Swagger with a great take to the hoop. Really showing off her speed and agility.
And don't think for a second, Bo, she's not going to try and combat some of those misses she had in the first half by coming out with her foot on the pedal right away.
Carl's losing the ball.
A little bit of contact, but no call. No call again. That inbound pass, they set up a screen there for Sydney Reed at the corner for a shot, but luckily the defense was able to set up and prevent a big shot.
Yeah, you've been seeing a lot of screens from Juniata. They really try to use those and get their shots open on offense.
Yeah, and a big factor between this lead probably is the fact that Bellwood's able to get back on defense on some of those screens and prevent big shots. But there was a jump ball right there. Sophie Damiano was able to grab it up. Unfortunately, position does go towards Juniata Valley.
Allie Campbell with a good effort to try to get that ball in the basket, but just doesn't seem to succeed.
Despite some missed shots early in the second half, it is a 10-point game, so the lead has grown a little bit for Bellwood. Smith's going to dribble around the perimeter and look inside. Tough D there by Damiano.
Carson unable to get her hands around that ball.
Lots of contact and one.
Tough take to the hoop by Juniata and they get the end one.
Both of these teams, you can tell they have some intensity. They want to win this game. They want to make a play because of how hard they attack the rim. They really want to get there. They want to get a foul. They want to get to the line. They want to score.
Keeping the ball moving. Swagger's got it back. She takes it to the hoop.
Just unlucky bounces tonight for her. Taylor Lady's been doing the controlling most of the offense for Juniata Valley, and you see that when they need to find someone, they'll give it to her.
Another missed shot from Juniata. It's really becoming a problem for them. Good take and a nice floater.
5-point game just like that, though. Momentum once again in favor of Juniata Valley.
Sophie Damiano with a nice cut to the rim and a good layup.
That is a pure read right there. She saw a hole in the key, went around the elbow, and went in for the easy layup.
The defense adjusting. Sophie trying to get good defense in there. Well, it's set up by five. D'Angelo with a nice pass out to Campbell. She's going to try to get to the hoop, but it's taken right out of her hands.
Oh.
This is going to be a foul on Juniata. Bellwood's ball.
See, Bellwood's trying something different. Instead of Campbell doing the inbound passing, they have Riley D'Angelo doing that. And that might be potentially to set up Campbell for some shots from the perimeter.
Good defense by Bellwood.
Ball goes to Bellwood. But you've seen earlier the referees, the officials are allowing calls like that when they drive in the lane. They're allowing them to get their hand on the ball and not calling any fouls.
D'Angelo fakes a shot. Carson shoots it.
Deep
three.
That's
nothing but buckets.
Buries it back up to an 8-point game, Bo.
Much needed shot for Bellwood. Juniata needs to get something going. Nice
shot from Lady off
the
mark.
Shot, but one fall.
That foul on the floor. You know, that shows a lot of confidence in Swagger to be able to just dominate who's defending her, take them where she wants, dribbles where she wants. And a lot of that leads to the scoring she's been able to put up. Again, 28 points per game, and she's really having a prolific season on the offense.
It's another shot by Swagger, but that one doesn't fall. Juniata, moving the ball, they get another shot off. They're now down by six. Hard pass by Damiano, and it's now back out to Carls. She's looking for an open pass. She gets it out to Damiano. Damiano's trying to see what she can work with. Swagger trying to get an open shot. They're really moving the ball. Campbell takes a shot.
Some of that ball movement really shows you the versatility of their offense. They don't really have a set post player. Like, Damiano can play the perimeter, and she's an integral part of the middleman. She can distribute the ball. She can catch and pass. And that really goes to the effectiveness of the offense. There weren't any subs there for Bellwood, were there? They're going to wait a little bit to get some fresh legs, maybe probably till the end of the quarter.
We're seeing some tough defense by Bellwood here. Swarter gets the ball, and she passes it down to Leidig. Leidig tries to take it to the hoop, but he's going to get a foul.
She walked first.
She's going to get another. Makes her second shot, and Juniata.
Point guard from the JV team, Reed, is able to take a shot there. She's getting some minutes in varsity tonight.
And Campbell's going to get a shot off.
Haley, shoot the ball!
Just a little cold. Juniata's going to take it to the rim, but
Haley, shoot the ball when you're open.
Juniata
they're going to call a shooting foul. She's going to get three foul shots on that. Call on Sophie Damiano. It's her third foul.
With just under a minute left here.
If I could speculate, I think Coach Sweeney's going to leave Damiano in the game because we're basically to the fourth quarter. If she's careful enough to get through this quarter without another foul, she should be set for the fourth quarter play. Engel comes in for Damiano. I'm wrong.
That shot's going to fall for Juniata. Carson really trying to get down the court aggressively, and she's going to get a nice easy layup.
Just like that, you look up at the scoreboard. Carson has 12 points now, and she's made up for that first half a couple misses.
Now you can see Bellwood just trying to keep control of the ball.
Hard
not
trip.
Not let Juniata score. As Campbell hits the ground hard there.
That never feels good.
Easy.
Knees off the hardwood. You can get a banged up knee, and we're thankful she's able to get up.
Campbell shakes it off, and she gets back in there. Swagger.
So far, we don't see nearly the production that Bellwood had at their last game against Glendale. The final score there, 94-27. They were able to really get rolling. They had a couple players on the floor that were hot all at once, and that all came together for a near 100-point performance.
Michaela Carl's going to get some foul shots here.
Back up to an 8-point lead here with 16 left in the quarter.
Juniata really needs some momentum.
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure about that call.
And Juniata's going to get their foul shots again.
Seconds even left on the clock. We'll see what Bellwood does. Probably going to take their time on this last possession of the quarter.
Swagger takes a shot. Doesn't fall. Bellwood has the ball back. And that's the quarter.
Left to play, Bo. We got a 6-point game, and this is starting to look like the type of game we had last time, January 17th. Bellwood actually was down at this point in the game. It didn't happen until the last couple minutes. Riley D'Angelo hit a big three to put them ahead and by five, which kind of closed out the game. And hopefully Bellwood can have that luck at this game, last 8 minutes, to keep the lead momentum in their favor. One quarter left to play, major ICC implications left. Right now, Bellwood looks like they can be the third seed, and hopefully that stays the same throughout the rest of the quarter. winner of this game will play for the ICC title next Saturday. Someone's got to get that lid off the basket for Bellwood. They have the ball there. It's just floating right over the hole.
Juniata really creeping up on him now. Closing the lead by, flipping the lead to four.
They're going to call a foul there on the floor.
And that's another foul by Bellwood. That's not looking good.
That's the fifth team foul here, and something Bellwood can't afford to do is allow Juniata Valley to get into the bonus this early in the final quarter. They have three fouls to give, and hopefully they can limit that in the last 6.5 minutes. Smith with the basket. And these last 6 minutes, look for Smith to really press for Juniata Valley, one of their top playmakers who can make something happen on the offensive side.
So we're coming down to the wire here. Campbell misses that shot. D'Angelo gets it.
And a 2-point game, a basket here for Bellwood would be big and could completely shift the momentum, which appears to be 100% away from them now with some missed shots.
Slaughter with the and one. That set a good tone for the team here.
Team points now for Swagger. Just under 6 minutes left. A 5-point game on hand.
This is going to be a tough quarter for Bellwood as they need to maintain this lead to seal this victory.
Starting to see the tide turn a little bit here in the last 5.5 minutes. in terms of officiating. Earlier in the game, we saw lots of contact on the ball and bumps, and now we're starting to see that change a little bit as they're trying to get an even game, avoid any controversial calls. Great post defense there by Bellwood. You see that didn't allow the pass into the post. This game just got a lot more interesting. Back to two with five left. D'Angelo, that's a little bit like deja vu, as she did the same thing in the last meeting at this point in the game. And it also made the last game a 5-point lead. Big board there by Damiana to change possession. Jeffrey's going to check into the game for Juniata Valley for Maddie Modis.
That shot's going to fall also.
But back to that substitution for Juniata Valley, that's pretty big because you see they're starting to go with the smaller lineup with about 4 minutes left. Probably for offensive purposes, but what that does is get to the size of the post.
Major cure here is the ladies need to keep up a good defense so they can keep out these Juniata Valley Hornets from scoring.
We've seen a similar lineup for most of the second half, not much substitution for Bellwood, which goes to show you that the stamina of this team, the conditioning is really starting to pay off as these girls are really made to play in games like this, last the whole second half, and they can stay in without fatigue setting in. We're back up to a 7-point game. And it seems games like this, those lead changes and growing of leads like that goes a little unnoticed because in the blink of an eye it could be back to a tie game, 2-point game, just with a couple big shots.
Nice pass. This shot's not going to fall.
Bellwood is now. Eight team fouls for Juniata Valley. One and one is converted though. And the Blue Devils, just like that, are creeping back up to a 10-point lead. We'll see what Juniata Valley can do. They've been able to limit some of the damage that Bellwood's been able to do, not letting them stretch their leads out too far. They've been able to respond.
Nice take by Juniata. That's going to result in 2 points.
Yeah. Swagger starting to slow down the tempo there. Maybe try to chew some clock, set a play up here.
Carson taking the shot. Bellwood keeping the ball moving.
Nice pass to the post. Points for Swagger. She's creeping up on similar numbers from their last meeting in which she had 22 points. I'll tell you what, but Juniata Valley fans really wanted a call on that as the time starting to get a little bit smaller here, down to 2.5 minutes left.
Nice takeaway from Juniata Valley, but they can't get that layup. Juniata Valley's gonna get their foul shots as a result. Bellwood taking an 8-point lead with two minutes left.
Seven-point game. Juniata Valley starting to put the press on.
Really trying to put the pressure on the
I'll tell you what, that's something we haven't seen much from Bellwood today is the press, which is really what they're known for, which is allows them to, you know, cause some turnovers on the other side of the court and get an easy basket.
More of a conservative defensive game.
Bellwood now in the double bonus with that 10th team foul from Juniata Valley. So Campbell's going to have an opportunity to get two. Juniata Valley's really limited her scoring in the second half, and I'm not sure she has a basket.
first points Campbell's put up since the half. And good defense.
Looks like Juniata Valley is going to start fouling here with a minute 14 left. Two shots now for Carson Swager, who already has 20 in the game. She converts on the first one. Spin move there allowed her to get that easy layup once the defender went through, overshot her man.
That's a slip up.
Swager's gonna head to the line again. 33 seconds left in the game. Two Blue Devils back, ready to play some quick defense. With that foul shot, Swager has matched her point totals from the January 17th matchup. And Juniata Valley is going to take a timeout, one left. Thank you.
shot from Riley D'Angelo.
Riley's got 8 points in the game. Can make it double figure scoring for her.
First one's.
And it's back up to a 10-point game.
It looks like this victory could be sealed for the Lady Blue Devils.
Floater's too hard.
Wow, nice rebound from Juniata Valley. Juniata Valley still finally got points.
Tough inside defense, but you gotta tip your hat to Lady of Juniata Valley for using some strength to put that in.
Special thanks to you and all students and staff helping with tonight's broadcast.
Go.